Some of you may be wondering what game engines are, which ones are the best, and what makes the difference between several engines. That's our topic for today. To put things simply, an engine is a software layer that serves as a foundation for your game. An engine gives you access to functions that facilitate game creation. It can be loading files from the drive, rendering pictures on the screen, animating them, handling sounds, physics, all sorts of things. An engine can come with an editor or not. An engine is defined by the base of code that runs your game, not the presence of an editor in particular. You may have already heard the word framework. A framework is an ensemble of libraries that give solid foundations to create certain types of applications. In the world of video games, the difference between an engine and a framework is blurry. Both terms are often used interchangeably. There are tons of game engines. Pixel Prospector's big list of game-making tools, which only contains famous names, lists about 30. I'm leaving the link in the description below. So, which one should you pick? Which one is the best? The answer isn't obvious. There is no one best engine, only some better engines for oneself. It's a personal choice that you have to make based on your experience and your project's needs. Here are 6 aspects on which you can base your reflection to find an engine that will work for you. First of all, functionality. It's generally the variety of available functions that attracts people towards a certain tool. Does the engine come with an editor? Does it support 3D rendering or advanced physics? Then come performances. Is a game made with this engine lightweight? Some are optimized for mid-sized games, not for web or old mobile devices. That's the case for Unity or Unreal, for instance. Today, the ability to port game is essential. Which platforms does the engine support? How much does it cost to port a game? And are there limitations on various platforms? Ergonomics make or break a tool for me, but they may not be that important for everyone. Yet, is it simple to write and read code with this engine? Are its website and the manual well-structured? Is the engine designed for a large team or a single user? It's also important to ensure that the engine is kept up to date. Are bugs fixed and fixed quickly? Are the updates substantial? Most engines offer a detailed log of every update. Some even have a roadmap, which gives an idea of upcoming features and their estimated time of arrival. And there's the community. How many active users are there? Is the community friendly or does it feel rather closed? Are there more beginners or professionals using the engine? We could also add the cost to the list. Is the tool expensive? Do you have to pay a monthly fee to use it? This list asks many questions. It's up to everyone to find their answers, as they will depend on everyone's needs. Sadly, there is no magic solution to make the right choice. You have to try various tools and take the time to get used to them before you find a match. If you need to compare multiple engines, I advise you to make the same small game with every tool. This is a good way to see which one you like best. Here are a few engine recommendations for people who might feel a bit lost with this video. If you have never written code or have little experience with programming, tools like Constructor or GameMaker are the easiest ones to start with. In both cases, the advantage is that you will find a large, active community with lots of resources to learn quickly. For those of you who want to code directly with JavaScript, Phaser is a rich and well-maintained framework. And for those of you who want to make native computer games and have a bit of experience with programming, Unity is an excellent choice. Its community is gigantic, tutorials abound, and this engine is pretty mature. If you like the video, you can hit the like button, become a subscriber to support the channel, or share it with your friends. I want to thank you all for watching. Be creative, have fun, until next time.